How much bandwidth does Skype for Business actually use? This is information that could be helpful to you to plan out your implementation of Skype across your network. Let's take a look at the various uses for Skype and see some of the numbers. When Skype for Business is running in the background with no other activity, it's almost undetectable the amount of bandwidth that it uses. So let's first take a look and see what happens when you instant message an account. Looks like it peaks at about 0.1 megabits. Now let's connect into a phone call. As you can see, it still appears to be peaking at about 0.1 megabits. And let's compare it with a video share. You can see it tops out at about 0.9, 0.8. Now, as a comparison, let's add a third phone user into the mix. Now, what's interesting is you can see the actual bandwidth usage dropped to about 0.4, 0.5. What it appears Skype for Business is doing is spreading that bandwidth among the multiple calls that you have active at one time. You also have to keep in mind that this bandwidth doesn't necessarily represent what's going out across the internet versus what's going across your network. So depending on what type of connection you have will make a difference in determining what internet bandwidth you'll need to use. This chart represents the recommended download and upload speeds for the various uses of Skype for Business. As you can see in the chart, even the high-def video calling is about 1.5 megabits. And as you add additional users, the individual rate drops for each user. But for calculation purposes, let's assume 1.5 megabits is needed for each connection that's going on simultaneously in your office. I have 250 users in my office environment, and they all run Skype for Business. Over the 180-day period previous to this video, the peak usage was 74 in a given day. That's 74 video calls in an 8-hour period, so that would be no more than 10 on average at any given hour. At 1.5 megabit per connection, that leaves you with 15 megabit as a maximum amount of usage at any one point in time. Now, it's entirely possible that somebody could send an invite out for a video conference with 100 people on it, in which case you could have 150 megabit of bandwidth usage. But remember, the bandwidth for most of those connections would be internal to your network and not external across your internet. So you have to consider how many people are actually remote and how many people are internal on your network. As a safe bet, I suggest you take 1.5 megabits times the number of users that you expect to be connected at any one given point in time in a remote type of meeting. And that should give you an indication of what you need to plan for as a maximum. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.